Thank you for joining us today. This webinar will help you better understand the SmarterMeasure Assessment, help you decide if online courses are right for you, and help you get started in your online courses. SmarterMeasure is an assessment available in all ELI courses and helps you gauge your readiness for online learning. The Extended Learning Institute is also referred to as ELI and is the online division here at Nova. If you want to discuss your results with an ELI academic counselor, counselors are available by email at elicounselors@mvcc.edu or at 703-323-3347. In today's presentation, we will cover what is the SmarterMeasure Assessment, how do you access the assessment, how to re-enter the site, how to send your results to your instructor, and what you'll learn about yourself. We use SmarterMeasure as a tool to help new and potential students gauge their readiness for online learning. Students thinking about taking an ELI course can gain access to this tool, and instructors use this tool to help students get started in their online course. This assessment is not graded and will have no impact on enrollment in courses, so be honest with yourself as you answer the questions in each of the sections. The results will give you feedback about your strengths and challenges for online learning. The results will give you techniques to help you succeed in your courses and is meant to give you a good overall assessment of your readiness. If you are enrolled in an ELI course and have access to your Blackboard course site, you can find the information to access the assessment in the welcome section of your course. If you are thinking about enrolling in an online course or have not started your course yet, you can gain access to the assessment through the main ELI website. Once you log into the SmarterMeasure Assessment webpage on ELI's website, you'll be prompted to select a username from the drop-down menu. If you don't have a username and password, you can email the ELI counselors for access. There's also a guest username and password in the welcome section of every Blackboard course site. The assessment will take about 30 minutes to complete, but you can stop in the middle and pick up where you left off. If you need to take a break in the middle of the assessment, you can re-enter the site with the PIN that will automatically be sent to the email you registered with. Once you're in the site, you will fill out your contact information. Once you enter your email, you will be sent an automatic email that you started the assessment, and it will include a PIN number. The PIN number can be used to re-enter the site. Remember what email address you used when registering so you can access that PIN and save that email so you have it at any point. If you're taking the assessment as part of your course and need to send the results to your instructor, you will want to download the results as a PDF and upload them to the assignments area of your Blackboard course site. If you are working with an instructor or an academic advisor outside of class, you can send the results as an attachment in the email, or you can send the email directly from SmarterMeasure. There is a place to add a message and also blind copy yourself so you know the email was sent. If this is a requirement for more than one of your courses, you will only need to take the assessment once, and you can upload those results to different Blackboard course sites. If this is an assignment for your class, your instructor will ask you to submit your results directly to the assignment link in Blackboard. If you choose to email your instructor, you will also want to make sure you go back and submit them in Blackboard so you don't miss any points. The assessment covers 6 competencies that are relevant to online learning. These sections are broken up and mostly multiple choice questions. The typing speed has you type up the statement for your results. Again, be honest with yourself for the best results. And once you get your results, you can read through the tips to help you improve. The first section is life factors. Many students strongly desire to continue their education. However, oftentimes other situations in life prevent them from being able to do so. The life factors section of SmarterMeasure asks questions about other elements in life that may impact your ability to continue your education. This section measures 5 items: time, place, reason, resources, and skills. You may be able to modify circumstances which impact some of your life skills. If so, you are encouraged to take a appropriate action to help yourself succeed. But some of the circumstances in life may be beyond your control. If this is the case, being aware of these realities and planning accordingly may be beneficial to you. ELI staff offers several webinars throughout the term to help you succeed in ELI courses. The next section is individual attributes. This section measures six items: time management, procrastination, persistence, academic attributes, locus of control, and willingness to ask for help. These attributes can be enhanced or improved through academic interventions. Ask your faculty member or academic advisor about the resources that are available to help you succeed. The ELI counselors hold a How to Succeed in Online Learning Courses webinar throughout the semester. They focus on time management to help you succeed in your courses. The next section is learning styles. People learn differently. Some people are very comfortable reading large amounts of text, while others are more comfortable listening to somebody speak or writing things down for themselves. A person's preferred learning style is the approach to learning that feels most natural to them. It is based on a combination of their experiences, strengths, weaknesses, and preferences. The next section is technical competencies, skills, and knowledge. Technical competency is important, but if you do not score high in this area, don't worry. The ability to comfortably learn is what's most important. You'll want to gain comfort in navigating the Blackboard course site so you can submit assignments, post on the discussion board, and select folders so you don't miss any coursework. A multitude of resources exist on the internet. Those listed in the technical competency summary are just a small sample of what's available in terms of information or tutorials on the topic focused in the SmarterMeasure assessment. The next section is reading recall. The average adult reading rate in the United States is around 250 to 300 words per minute. And the last section is typing speed and accuracy. A student does not have to be an expert typist to succeed in a course. However, the faster you can type with the fewer errors you make will impact your ability to participate in your course. These six sections will help you gauge your readiness for online learning and help you evaluate your strengths and challenges for online courses. Remember, your results will show your strengths and challenges. Your results will help you prepare and succeed in your courses, so answer honestly. You will see a summary, and then you can click on each link to get more information to improve your skills. You can log back in and access your results at any time with a PIN number set to you in your email. Thank you for joining us today. Let us know if you have any questions about the SmarterMeasure assessment or getting started in online courses at Nova. If you want to discuss your results, ELI counselors are available at elicounselors@mvcc.edu or by calling 703-323-3347. For more information about each competency, we would encourage you to view the transcript of this presentation and the ELI student blog.